When you're grinding at work, it's common to eventually crave a snack. In today's Wednesday's Reads, Eat Your Feelings is the book that shows you how you can transform your lifestyle by learning from your cravings to improve your mood. So joining me now to talk about this is book critic Gwen Reyes. Gwen, thank you so much for joining us. So apart from letting you know that you're hungry,
yes,
what exactly can your cravings tell you about yourself?
So your cravings can actually tell you, like, if you're hangry, which is really sort of your way of eating to deal with everything that's out of your control.
Okay.
If you're stressed out, if you're depressed, if you're unhappy, if you are happy, your cravings kind of hit all of those notes. And in this book, we really want to start attacking why you feel that way and how you can make better food choices.
And apparently certain foods will have a certain effect on your mood.
Yes, exactly. So like if you're in the mood for something sweet or something creamy, these are going to be things that are going to kind of make, kind of drain you. They make you feel excited and happy while you're eating them, but then they also drain you at the end.
High,
it's a temporary high.
Interesting. Mm-hmm. So do they actually break down specific foods, like ice cream or chocolate?
So what I thought was really interesting about this book was that the first like half of it, she really talks a lot about like why we have cravings, what the emotional connection to food is, and how we kind of have learned over years to deal with the things that are out of our control and our stressors in our lives by eating. And then in the last half of the book, she kind of goes each chapter and talks about sort of if you're craving something creamy, and she gives you healthier plant-based options that are going to hit those notes for you, or salty or crunchy or sweet.
Interesting that texture can actually have an impact on your mood too.
Yeah.
Is she actually giving you recipes or just sort of mentioning different snacks that you can pick up at a grocery store?
She does actually give you recipes in this and talks a lot about, in each chapter she's got it's a combination of diet book and cookbook.
Okay.
So you are going to be walking away with sort of self-help and self-healing things, but at the same time you're going to walk away with some new recipes.
Got to be honest with you though, I'm surprised to hear that she's sort of saying blanketly that if you're craving this food, that can mean this, because I would imagine people maybe go for foods for different reasons.
And I think because it's probably a lot to do with like how you were raised or the things that you're craving at the time that instantly, like for me, I'm a sweet tooth person. And so if I'm really stressed out at work or something's going on, I instantly want to gravitate towards some chocolate because the chemicals in that instantly soothe me.
Okay, so this is an interesting book, but I will say being aware of your cravings and your issues and actually doing something about them can be tough.
It's very tough, but you know what? Take the craving, but eat something that's not going to make you hate yourself later.
Good
that's
advice
the
there.
Best advice.
Thank you, Gwen. Thank you so much, Alicia, for joining us this afternoon. So when we come back,